Today's program is about shopping online. How to secure yourself when shopping online.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Today we will be looking at online shopping. I know our interest is cryptocurrencies, but we are a little broader now. We are also looking at internet security, economy, and cryptocurrency. But for this program, we will be showing you how to secure yourself when shopping online. This applies to every type of shop, even in cryptocurrencies. We will be going over how to use reviews. We will be going over how to protect yourself using different services. And we will end on shopping from China.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
When purchasing online using a site just as Amazon or any other recognized site, you can mostly shop safely. And that's why we will use Amazon, because I like it. I like to use it. So what would you be looking for here? Well, I would be looking for a well-made site. And Amazon, well, that's well made. It comes with relevant information to you. And get to know you have a lot of option, payment option, shop with point, credit card marketplace. And you can get a lot of information. And that's help you, return and replacement policies. And they have thought of many things. Another great way of checking up on a site, if it were a bit dodgy, well, there's a way. I will return to that in a bit. First of all, on Amazon, I would look for this security icon if I'm using Chrome. And as you know, you can click on it. You can get connection is secured. Your information such as password, credit card numbers is private when you send it to Amazon. And let's just go back to the bottom. Amazon Prime, a return and replacement policy. That's a good thing to go in and read. And notice here, they have actually made it quite simple. Print the label and authorization. Prepare the package, attach return label, ship it. It is made very simple. Return sender, start return, return a gift, view return status. So they have made it quite simple. They have even written over here the most frequently asked questions, such as what you can return, when you will get your refund, does Amazon offer replacement and exchanges. Well thought out, easy to understand. But if you are using a more judgy site than Amazon, they might have made it just as easy, but you are insecure about the site. So you will go over to Trustpilot. Here, I'm not interested in the good reviews. I'm interested in the overall rating. On Amazon, it's 3 stars. But once I go down, I want to read, why does it get 3 stars? Nice and easy to order online. They're getting it 3 stars because it's nice and easy to order online. We'll be using it again, only very easy service. Well, why not give it more? Simple, I shop a lot on Amazon and I order shoes, but never again. Oh, here's something that is not that positive. I shop a lot of on Amazon and I order shoes, slippers, boots, etc. But I noticed when I do purchase a pair, they are always irregular and nothing like the description. There you end up with bad product or spend a fortune on shipping when shipping was free to you. I think it should be illegal to sell anything like shoes, especially irregular, on Amazon. So we know it's, we are not supposed to buy shoes from there because they're irregular. This is useful because, besides of the bad wording, which I also have sometimes, then you get some concrete. You get the concrete that the shoes are badly fitted and they're irregular. So we will move on and see what else is there. I know they are a huge company, or they're a huge company, Monoplies, but their shopping platform allows sellers and buyers some great opportunities for marketplace. I found some great shirts that I couldn't find in local Macy's. I'm a seller on Amazon. I mean, oh, here's something very negative. I'm a seller on Amazon. Without any important reason, they suspended my account. There is no reason to open it again. You get answered mails only by automatically sent call center. We should not support Amazon by selling or buying something on this platform, since they do not pay any fees in Europe. Thousands of sellers and clients complain that thousands of sellers and buyers complain. That may be a little exaggerated. But Bridget Huisman, I think it is, did have a bad experience. But you only have it from one side without any reason. We don't know what the reason are. There might actually be a reason. And I would have loved for her to disclose some of the automatically sent mails, so I could form my own opinion. I look for objective reviews. Here, Amazon Prime failing to deliver. Dear Amazon, why do you use DPD for delivery when they don't deliver to me? I've had 6 failed deliveries and complained to both you and DPD, but no improvement. If Amazon Prime cannot deliver in 1 day, they don't say you can. Then don't say you can. It is false advertisement and misleading use another carrier, or I will stop purchasing from you and cancel my Amazon Prime membership. Alright, so you need to be aware that DPD may have a little trouble delivering to your address. It would be nice to know approximately where are the address. Is it in a rural area? Is it in a big city? Because I believe that 1 day delivery DPD can do if you live in one of the major US metropolitans. But if you live way outside of any known city, they might be a little bit slower. But of course, they should not promise 1 day delivery if they cannot do it. And then you can read on. There are a lot of extremely pleased, good service. I don't like to read those. I read the negative. I read what they're negative about. And most importantly, they may not be too subjective. I need something concrete. I ordered this, it did that, and so on. Not that, oh, I am unsatisfied because you closed my account without reason. And there's nothing more. Then I want to know, what have they answered? That is what helps me. Also remember that if you're writing your own review, the more information that can help others form their own opinion, the better. And that's how I use Trustpilot. And as you can see on Amazon, there's 173 pages. That's as much for a shop. But the fewest people are leaving reviews. Another great way of getting an overview is that I use this one up here. Mostly excellent. There are some great, some average, some poor. But I also notice out of 4,891 reviews, 593 of them is actually bad reviews. And you can filter them to 1-star reviews. And then go through what is it that people are complaining about. Is it relevant to you? Always take into account, is it relevant to you? If people are complaining, oh, I got these shoes and you won't exchange them after 30 days because I have used them. Well, as long as the service does not say satisfactory guaranteed, why should they return the product you have begun using? And so on. So remember, read it and use your common sense when you're reading. Also, if you leave a review, use your common sense. Leave something people can use. Another great way of protecting you is using PayPal. If a shop is using PayPal, then you have a extra layer of protection, which they offer to you. They take a little fee for that, but that's not much. I use it often when I'm purchasing online, especially from sites that has a lesser reputation, because they have buyer's protection. If your eligible purchase doesn't arrive or doesn't match the seller's description, we can reimburse you. So they take their money back and give your money back. They have fraud protection. They monitor every transaction 24/7 to prevent fraud, email phishing, and identity theft. Every transaction is encrypted using our advanced encryption technology. When you purchase with PayPal from a store, you push the PayPal button, you'll get over to PayPal's site. They make the transaction through their secured connection before you go back to the seller. And there are some guidelines to how it works, what is not covered. You should know that what is not covered by PayPal's buyer's protection is real estate, because that's really many money. Motorized vehicle of any kind, so if it has a motor, it is not covered. Custom made items, because they are made to order. Industrial machinery for manufacturing. Prepaid cards. If you're buying a prepaid card to Amazon as a gift, they cannot reimburse you if the seller does not deliver. Items that violate our policies. Well, that is self-explanatory. Anything you buy in person. So if you're using the PayPal app on your phone and you purchase in a store, which you can do in some stores, they cannot reimburse you. Money transferred to friends and family. So if you are, for example, using the PayPal Me link on our site, I will just show you here. If you're using this link, PayPal Me, you will get in on the site here. You can choose whatever currency you want to donate, and it will transfer to my PayPal account. They cannot reimburse you, because PayPal Me is a friends and family and donations, and they cannot be refunded. But let's look at the examples of things you can get. You bought a book but got a DVD. That is quite misleading. You bought a new item but got something used. You purchased 3 items but only got 2. Your purchase was damaged in transit. The delivery was missing major part that the seller did not disclose. And you bought an authentic brand but got a knockoff instead. So, let's say you are buying a Rolex watch, you of course need to use your common sense. If you're buying a premium Rolex watch, normal price $100,000, but you can get it for 10, it is a knockoff, and they will probably not reimburse you, or you will have a hard time convincing them at least. But if it seems legit and it is a knockoff, you will get reimbursed. I've actually done this because I have bought a graphic card for my computer. I was told it was an Nvidia GeForce GTX 1070. And I have paid what was close to full price. It was with a 10% discount of the closest legitimate store, which I know had the graphic card. What I got instead was not a graphic card. It was a lot to win a graphic card. There were nowhere in the description that it stated it was a lot to win a graphic card. So there I got, well, major parts missing, or actually don't got the item. So they reimbursed me, and there was no hassle in it. And let's just look at the guidelines. If this happens, you won't be covered. Well, if the seller actually describes an item, but you weren't happy with it, this will not be covered. It is not a satisfactory guarantee, it's a bias protection. You fail to open a dispute within 180 days of purchase. Your account is not in good standing. If you misuse your account, you will not be protected by bias protection. I know someone who were not covered because, well, he have misused his account and he has filed dispute upon dispute upon dispute for something that were not covered. But he also got a mail that he was not protected anymore. Well, it is a great system, but they also have to take care of themselves. And I would say if you are just using your account for ordinary purchases and not misusing it to file dispute upon dispute when there's nothing to dispute, you are pretty well good standing, and you will be able to be protected by bias and fraud protection. It is just important that you remember these items that is not covered when you're purchasing. But if you're purchasing standardized items, mass produced, and there are some of the before mentioned flaws in the delivery, make sure to open and file a complaint or dispute, as they call it. Another way, since you're using your credit card, is that you can actually file a dispute through your credit card provider. I know in Denmark I have to go down to the bank and do it. It might vary a little from country to country, but it is always the provider can answer how you do it. So if you are using a local bank, go down to them. The card provider, not the issuer. The issuer is either Visa or MasterCard in many countries. But it is the provider you have purchased the card or gotten the card through. So just go down, talk to them if you have a dispute. But I would say PayPal have made it a little bit easier than most card providers and card issuers. And one last note, while on PayPal, it also has seller's protection. If you're selling items using PayPal, You have protected sales. You need to deliver proof of delivery. There are still items that is not covered. You get verified buyers, and you get support, a great support. And they are never closed. They have world-class security, and they mean it. They have it. I think they do, at least. So even if you are a seller, you are also protected, and it just gives you an extra layer of security. Just yet last, I want to tell you a little bit about using sites such as WishGeek, Light in the Box, Minion in the Box, where you purchase from China. There are some things you need to be aware of. A good example is on graphic cards. I weren't able to find anyone this time, but sometimes in the description of the product, there will stand that you are participating in a lottery. But even if it doesn't stand there, a GTX 1060 3D's DDR5 graphic card, well, I would not expect it to be that graphic card that comes in the mail. If it is, great. But as you have seen, probably many YouTubers have ordered such a thing as graphic cards or other more expensive items for very cheap, and they have gotten a rubber duck or something like that. So make sure that if you are purchasing items from Chinese manufacturers, read the description, think to yourself, can this be true? Is it too good a price? If it is too good a price to be true, it probably is. Just stumble upon the words there. Then you have something like this, a Zotac GTX 1060 independent 5D destroyer desktop card computer, dual fan, normal price, 1,980 US dollar, on sale for $1,550 US dollar. And you can buy with others and get it all the way down to $1,395. Here I would be, well, I would actually believe I get this card. I will not expect it to be the same quality as if I have gotten it from my local retailer. Or you risk every instruction is in Chinese. That you can also risk. So when you're purchasing on sites like this, don't expect the product to be as it is. And many of the retailers are holding to Chinese law, so they are not committing fraud according to the Chinese. But in the Western world, it would be considered either fraud or false advertisement or misleading products. But you will also get great products. If you go into my order history, it has been a little while since I ordered from Wish. But something like this, a portable, can we open it here? Yes. Something like this, a portable 5000 lumen ultra bright tactical LED flashlight. It is not as powerful as this picture, but it is up there. I have gotten, and we have actually tried testing it out because I have access to a test bench where I can test the lumens. And it was not 5000, it was only 4000 lumens. That's still a hell of a lot for $5. I cannot go down to my local store and get 4,000 lumens flashlight for $5. That's impossible. Just returning to my order history, there have been some things I have been more happy about. Like these, if I purchase, I believe I also got them for free. Just pay for the delivery. these have held better than what I would expect. These hooks have, I have had them holding a, what do you call it in English, some cloth which is out in the wind. And even strong winds, they don't bend. If I purchase something looking like that in my local store here in Denmark, I would probably pay around $5 for them a piece. I've gotten 10 pieces for free here. And they would bend just by looking at them. So you can also get great products. The only thing I have been disappointed about, I have ordered, and you can see I have ordered quite a lot of products. Even a stethoscope, that's because I work in nursing. And I have to supply my own stethoscope if I am to use one. And, well, that was for my ex-wife, girlfriend, something like that. And, oh yeah, you can see I'm a Star Trek fan. But the only thing I have been truly disappointed about, I have ordered, and you can see there's a lot of things, as I mentioned, it's up here. Oh, went a little too far. Here, the microphone. This microphone is great for, as they have pictured here, a central meeting. Just put it in the middle, it will capture everything you say. But if you're making a speech for a YouTube channel or something like that, or playing music, well, the sound is bad. It takes up all the noise, so even if I got some train driving by, I live close to the station. If I got a train driving by, even when I had closed doors, well, it captured the train also. So it's an extremely sensitive mic. And that was a little disappointing. It captured too much. But what can you expect for $10? I have then used it when we are making group calls. When I was with some of my friends, we made some group calls where we had meetings in different parts of Denmark. Then we could place it in the middle and the other end could hear everything. And since we were not too close on it, it would not take those breathings in when you, like you're blowing into the mic. But if you're too close to the microphone, it will also, every time you take a breath, it will capture that. So a little disappointing, I could not use it for what I was intending, but it was not mislabeled in any way. So cheap products, well, I wouldn't mind buying them. And I would love to purchase even more from Wish and test it out and show it to you, but that requires your support. If you support us, I will also begin a series where I will order items from Wish and show them to you. But for now, you have to make do with good internet security, and our focus is cryptocurrency, economy, and internet security. So, I want to thank you for watching, and until next time, have a great week, and bye-bye!